The Taliban movement emerged in Afghanistan in 1994. And in 1995, I was traveling with the then Prime Minister of Pakistan, Benazir Bhutto, to United States. There was, I remember, 50th anniversary of United Nations. And I remember that Benazir Bhutto met Ambassador Robin Rafael in New York. And we came to know that Ambassador Robin Rafael asked Benazir Bhutto to announce her support for Afghan Taliban. And it was, you see, very disturbing thing. And I wrote a column from New York that here is the first elected Muslim female prime minister, not only in Pakistan, but in the whole Muslim world. She is the first elected woman prime minister. Afghan Taliban are imposing ban on the girls' education in Afghanistan, and she has been asked by Robin Rafael, another female, to announce her support for the Afghan Taliban. So in those days, the journalist who used to travel with Prime Minister, hum ek hi jahaz mein safar karte the. So when we were coming back from the New York, I was not aware that the press information department from Islamabad, they faxed my column to the press information, press consular in New York, and he made a file and presented it to the Prime Minister. So the Prime Minister called me in the plane. And she said, oh, you are criticizing me. I said, yes, because this is democracy, and I don't like Taliban, and you are supporting Taliban, and on the behest of Robin Rafael. So she asked her interior minister, Nasirullah Babar. By the way, in those days, Shafkat Musa was also part of People's Party. But he was not,
in that plane.
In that plane, yeah. So when the interior minister was asked to brief me why Taliban are good for Pakistan. So we reached back to Pakistan, and after a few days, another colleague of mine, his name is Nusrat Javed. So the interior minister organized a briefing for me and Nusrat Javed, and they explained that we are using Taliban as the pipeline police. We want a gas pipeline from Uzbekistan to Pakistan, and there is nobody who can protect the gas pipeline because the government in Kabul, Northern Alliance, is supported by the Indians and the Iranians, and they may destroy the gas pipeline. So it will come through an area where Afghan Taliban can protect the gas pipeline. So that's why we are promoting this militia, that they may help our economic interest. So then I said, okay, I would like to meet Mullah Omar. So my interior minister said, okay, we will fix your meeting. And within few days, by the way, my colleague Nusrat Javed refused to meet him. He said, I cannot meet a person who is imposing ban on the girls' education. So I said, okay, I will meet him. So I met him in Kandahar. It was a very interesting meeting. And when he asked me that, why do you write against me? So I said, because you are working for the Americans. He said, how can you prove that? I said, because Robin Rafael is supporting you. He said, who is Robin Rafael? I said, she is a lady. He said, la haul wa la quwwata illa billah. A lady is supporting me.
That's a good one.
So then I was astonished, and I thought that he is not aware that Robin Rafael is a male or a female. And my interpreter was a young Afghan boy. And I looked towards him, and he was just smiling. So then he said, you see, the Radio Tehran is exploiting your column. So last two nights, Radio Tehran is using your column and defaming me and saying Mullah Omar is an American agent. So I said, if the US Assistant Secretary of State is supporting you, and I am an evidence, I am an eyewitness. Prime Minister of Pakistan was asked by Robin Rafael to support you, so you are working for them. He said, okay, if I fix your meeting with a big enemy of America, then will you write that I am not an American agent? I said, who is that enemy? He said, Osama bin Laden. So this is, end of 95. And Osama bin Laden was not in Afghanistan at that time. So some time passed, and he came to Afghanistan in May 1996. And then the government of Benazir Bhutto was toppled in November 1996. Nawaz Sharif came into power. And in March 1997, I was contacted by the information minister of Afghan government. His name was Amir Khan Muttaqi. So he said, do you remember your meeting with Mullah Omar, which was organized by Nasirullah Babar? I said, yes. So he said, he made a promise with you, and he is a man who always fulfills his promise. So your meeting is fixed and you have to go. So that's how my first meeting with Osama bin Laden was organized in Tora Bora by Mullah Omar, but thanks to Benazir Bhutto and Nasirullah Babar.
And you also met Osama bin Laden after 9/11.
No, I met him again in 1998. Interestingly, when I was going to meet him in 1998, I was arrested by Taliban because they came to know that I will go and interview him. And in those days, they were under the pressure of the Nawaz Sharif government that you should impose some restrictions on Osama bin Laden on the American pressure. So I was arrested and then I was released because the police station in which I was detained was attacked by Al-Qaeda. So I came to know about their internal differences and contradictions. And then after 9/11, in November 2001, I met him again. That was the third interview. I asked him many questions. And the main question was that why you organized these attacks in New York and Washington. And he was not accepting the responsibility directly, but he was praising all those who were part of that attack. And then he criticized the Pakistan government's policies. And then I asked him questions that there was a rumor that Osama bin Laden married with the daughter of Mullah Omar. He said no. So there were a lot of, you see, there was a change in his attitude, because when I interviewed him first time in 1997, at that time he was not talking about Palestine, and he was not talking about international jihad against America. In 1997, he was proposing a regional alliance between Afghanistan, Pakistan, Iran, and China. His thinking was strategic. But after 9/11, when I met him, he was talking about this Khilafat and international jihad against America and Palestine. In 1997, he was talking about regional alliance. In 2001, he was talking about international jihad. So he was a changed man. And I thought maybe because his close association with Dr. Zubari.
Was he soft-spoken?
Yes, he was. You see, there was a big contradiction between his action and his way of speaking. And I must say that whenever I met him, I got an impression that I'm meeting with a lady killer.
Lady killer,
yeah. Very smart, very charming.
You mean charming?
Robin Raphael.
Charming.
Do you think, you know, you met him so many times and you followed the whole story. Did his death make a substantive difference to the Al-Qaeda, to terrorism in the region? Do you think if he had been alive, it would have been different?
I think that he was a threat for the peace in this region, and he was definitely sleeping. He was not issuing his video or audio messages for a very long time, but he was making contacts with different groups, not only in Pakistani tribal areas, but Somalia, Iraq, okay? And this Asim Umar, the new Al-Qaeda chief of the South Asia chapter, he was also in contact with him. And the Americans discovered some documents from his hiding place, and they killed him. And they were going back. They confiscated some computers and documents. So through those documents, it was discovered that he was in contact, and he was trying to organize some more attacks, not in this region, but outside this region. And after his death, I think that Al-Qaeda was shattered, but now they are reorganizing Al-Qaeda. And I think that this new South Asia chapter of Al-Qaeda, it is very dangerous. We should not underestimate them. Why I say that? Because right now there is a lot of tension between India and Pakistan. And if India and Pakistan, God forbid, if they fight with each other, they will be the ultimate beneficiary. They can organize a big attack in India, a big attack in Pakistan, maybe in Afghanistan, and they will, if there is a hard response from India or Pakistan and a warlike situation created, so they will be successful in their strategy. So we should be very careful about that.
I just want to re-emphasize this last point, because we keep hearing from some of our Indian officials and so on that if there is another terrorist attack in India, or large-scale terrorist attack, like the unfortunate tragedy in Mumbai, that may provoke an all-out war. And as Hamid has just said, that there are forces in the region who would like to provoke such a war. So therefore, it won't surprise me if they try and either provoke an attack in Pakistan and somehow link it with hardline elements here, or the other way around. So I think we need to flag this in our minds, and also flag this if possible, so that we have a common enemy, and that common enemy are these terrorists who could create a problem between our countries.